Sexy. Morning. Hey, Robert Helshamine, how you doing? I didn't think you'd be awake. Oh my gosh. How you all doing? Sweetheart, how are you? Oh my gosh, it's a pleasure to have you all here. Oh my word, I'm literally doing this live. You know why? I've got a face on, and before I take it off, I literally need to capture this moment. I really do need to catch this. Hey, Samara. So yeah, I just wanted to, you know me already. Sunday/Monday, I try and just jump on quickly and just give thanks for the last 7 days. And it's been a real interesting week. I just wanted to just share some of it with you, to be quite honest. I was like, I've got this energy and I needed to kind of just share and just hopefully kind of put some positivity your way, to be quite honest with you. I was just watching a good friend of mine. He was doing a live stream. He's Ricky J, depending on like which Facebook name he's using sort of thing, but by all means, like, you know, always sort of jump on his page and have a look at what he's doing. He's got some amazing content. He's a real, like, just a king amongst men, to be quite honest with you. He's very, very knowledgeable. So I was just sort of inspired by watching him a little while ago, and it was like, you know what, let me just jump on and say what it is that I've got to say, because he really impacted me. So, you know, this week has been a bit of an up and down one. I've been trying to build bridges, let's say, with some family members, without going into too much detail. You know, you have sort of those turbulent relationships with people where there's a miscommunication. It's like you're both firing, but you're kind of passing each other, you know what I mean, in that respect. And sometimes you have to slow down your relationship or slow down the interaction and learn how to communicate with that person again. You've both changed, you've spent time apart, you've both grown, you've both developed in different areas of your lives, and then you try to come back, but you kind of remember the person who they used to be, rather than looking at the person and the personality and the characteristics of the actual individual who's standing before you now. So although we look the same on the outside, we grow and we change and we learn, our language changes, our vocabulary changes, the people we're around changes. So when you have those breakdowns in relationships and the communication's not quite right and you leave it for a certain period of time, at that point we kind of use that language, oh well, I better be the bigger person and go back and, you know, and speak and or make contact, send that message, make that phone call. And yeah, that's right. I was just reading some of the comments in that respect. Thank you, Samara, for commenting. I will read them shortly as well. So as things are going up, you'll probably see me pause just to read them and that sort of thing. And there are instances where you're at the starting line in a friendship or in a relationship. And like Samara has actually put here, some people just can't let the past go. And what it is that we're not really supposed to let it go per se. And it's the emotion, I find that, and the feeling that we have attached to the relationship. It's not like we have to let it go, but we have to learn to either cope with it, heal from it, and learn from it, basically, is where I'm at. I realized that I was having a lot of interactions over the last year, and some of them were misfiring, because there were lots of people that I was around who, you know, you try to get to know people quite quick, especially using social media. So I vented because that person shut the door and didn't give me an opportunity to go back and explain or to try, you know, leave the door open in regards to rebuilding what could have been a decent friendship. So it's also happening with certain people in my family. Like I said, I think we're just misfiring in regards to communication because we've grown. It doesn't mean that we can't get along. It just means that we have to learn to speak to each other differently. There's a different vocabulary we have to use. So that's kind of where I'm at with like my relationships in regards to people. But again, I've had to deal with some loss. As we know, people come, people go. And then some people transition, they go to the other side. And I've had to say literally goodbye. I don't really use that word or that phrase very often, because to me it's very finite. So when somebody goes, it does make you wonder if you've said your final goodbyes, if you've you know, been able to express what it is you wanted to say to that person before you can't say it to them anymore. But, you know, they're just, do you delete the contact? Do you delete the WhatsApp in that respect? You know, so, and that's where I think some of us maybe need to sort of just look into ourselves a little bit. Are the relationships and people that we've walked away from where there's a possibility that when they're gone and we won't get an opportunity to say we're sorry or, you know, how are you doing? And, you know, because we've grown, we've changed and things happen. And it's just something to think about. And another friend of mine, and I will, hopefully he won't mind me naming him. His name's Efren. Last year I was going through a real turbulent time. And he stepped up as a friend. He was a stranger at first, met him on Facebook, and he stepped up and he offered me somewhere to stay temporarily while I got myself sorted out. And he's recently experienced a loss. And I just looked at a post and something that he put out where there's families out there that are struggling when they lose a relative or a friend, their mum, their sister, their brother, their child even. And then they have to think about funeral expenses and costs. And it's something that I've been talking about a long time. Sorry to be a bit dark on this part, but it's something I've been talking about for a long time. It's something that we know that's all coming. And if there's, for me, there's one thing that I don't want my family to have to think about when they're grieving, and that's money. Or we have to give her a decent burial. So it's something that we can actually look into for ourselves. Yeah, it's a bit morbid, I'm sorry. We can create wills, we can do things, we can leave our final wishes so our family actually know what we would like for them. And for me, it's to ease the burden, the financial burden. I would like them to just grieve and just remember me, you know, when that time comes. I don't want them to have to be thinking about how they're going to pay for a headstone or where they're going to put me and that sort of stuff. That's already taken care of. That was my responsibility. Which leads me into my next topic of our accountability and responsibility of adults. Now, I've been involved in a really, really good project, hence why the face is on today. I actually recorded a pilot show, something that could potentially be on TV, whether it be satellite or Netflix or wherever, you know what I mean, in that sense. So I wasn't actually on camera. No, I wasn't. I was prepared to go on camera just in case. But it's not something that I want to do yet. My skills are behind the scenes, organization, training, coaching, you know, motivating people to actually feel good, you know, making sure that the host and the co-host was all taken care of, and timekeeping. Like, that's just me. I'm like the military type, yeah, get it done type person. So yeah, they kind of put me in a position of authority where I could tell people to be quiet on set. You know, one of them ones there, action. You know, one of them, you're counting you in, and you've got 5 minutes, you've got 4 minutes. And I was proper, like, feeling myself. I'm not going to lie. Like, you can still tell that I'm proper still buzzing from it. And this is what it is. I'm going to show you the book, because I'm going to do advertise. Oh, yeah, there we go. Make sure it's in the light. It's called What to Do When Online Dating Hurts. This book, right? It is sad. It's funny. It's real life. It's somebody's experience when they did their online dating over a period of time. So we've actually kind of created this visually. So there's a podcast, there's a TV show, there's obviously the book, and whatever else comes with it. Do you know what I mean? So it's a pleasure. I actually interviewed Winsum. Her name's Winsum Duncan, everybody, okay? I won't tell you what websites, really, because I don't do advertising in that way. But obviously, if you type on, you know, when online dating hurts, or if you type in Winsum Duncan, okay, can you not see that? Can you see that? Can you see it? Can you see it? Can you see it? Right, just making sure. Screenshot, yeah? Flip it. But yes, what to do when online dating hurts? He loves me not. So we were created, like I said, a pilot show for that today. And I really stepped into myself, I stepped into my role. And it just feels really good. Like it feels like a baptism of fire. You know, when people kind of throw you into things and you either sink or you swim. And boy, am I swimming right about now. Literally like a swan out there. Yeah, underneath, still doing that. You know me already with my analogies. But on the surface, it was all calm. It was all calm. So thank you so much, you guys, for your comments. And I just want to just keep throwing the stuff out there. Right, next week, Saturday, as we know, March is kind of across the country, across the globe, we celebrate women. So it's International Women's Month, as far as I'm concerned. I'm not just into celebrating for a day. Me personally, I celebrate myself every day, but in regards to showing my gratitude and my appreciation for the women around me, I'm gonna be taking part in a few events. So Saturday, the 7th of March, I will be in Luton. I will you can look for my socials, but I'll throw them out there. I'll even drop some pictures at the bottom of this. And yes, Samara Sings, she's also in here. So for those of you who see Samara's comments, please feel free to check out her stuff. She's just an amazing, 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 amazing young person. And she is, again, one of the reasons why I do what it is that I do. I've made some stupid mistakes in my life. I really, really have. And now I go around and I try to inspire and help people from the silly decisions I made, literally through being in love, through not sort of thinking cohesively and divide. I made some real silly decisions, people, financially, emotionally, mentally. You know, it started to mess me up. So, you know, I've got involved with people who not just need my motivation and my inspiration, but who want to appreciate my energy, who want to kind of listen to what it is that I might have to say and find the solutions, because that's what I realize a lot of us are not offering. Yeah, let's just keep it real. We'll sit here and we'll talk about our problems until the cows literally come home by themselves. Yeah, I had to go out there and find solutions to what it is that I was dealing with. I had to find a way to fix my finances while I worked. I had to find a way to invest in a pension that's non-existent, because I never thought of those things when I was younger. I had to think of ways in which I could have multiple streams of income, and I'm just gonna keep it real, while still managing a 40-hour working week, perhaps a 60-hour working week. You know, this time last year, I was working 16 hours a day. Yeah, 14 hours on shift and an hour commute backwards and forwards. And I looked like a wreck. I thought I was actually doing something productive. Yes, I was within the role I was doing. I was a care worker, so I was physically looking after people, and that's where the reward came from. But in regards to my energy, my time and my bank account, I just wasn't making ends meet. Like I said, I've got myself into situations that I'm still paying for today. Literally, still paying for. So I've enabled myself to do other things around my working week. I work less hours for somebody else now, but I work more hours for me, on myself, with myself. And I advise as many people as possible to network whatever skill or talent it is that you have. And then because Dee Bailey, I'm gonna shout her out as well. She's the lady, sorry, I'm just getting out the adverts because I'm not paying for that silly thing. Right, that subscription. So yes, Dee Bailey, she is Dee Bailey's Events. If you want an event organizer and if you want some real, like, again, military position as to how things should be done, Dee is the woman for the job, definitely. And she's thrown me in there. She's offered me a life skills workshop, and I was like, it's not something that I've actually formally done before. But when I realize how many lives I've done, how many presentations I've given, and the fact that I talk about how I'm using the skills to better my life, it's kind of self-explanatory that I utilize this opportunity to reach as many people as I want. And it's not just about women, because it's International Women's Month. It's just that collectively as women, we've realized that we are going to empower each other, and we're going to support each other through the good times and through the bad, and we're going to encourage each other to shine. My infamous saying is, let's not compete, let's complete. Okay, so where I feel like I'm slacking, my sister to my side will pick up the slack and help me to feel complete. Yeah, that's where I'm at in life. That's what it is that I'm doing. So I'm gonna take this time to go and get some rest. Okay, and thank you so much. Thank you so much for just being part of this journey. Please, as I said, I don't do much promoting on my page, but what I do promote is because it will actually help. Not just with online dating, but looking at the things that happen behind the scenes, why people maybe overeat, maybe like myself, undereat, the health situations and the conditions that come along with wanting to open yourself up to a relationship, that come with the interactions that we have around. So that's why I utilize these self-help skills, is what I call them, okay? because they do eventually contribute to me being a better person, to me actually meeting somebody and being a better person, not for that person, because we're both elevating each other to that next step. So yeah, it's funny, it's sad, it's a bit shocking, and I relate to some of it because I've done a bit of online dating myself. So, but you'll have to tune into the pilot show. You'll have to, like, you know what I mean? I'm not gonna reveal too much about what it is. You look, you know what I mean? We're gonna put some footage out there, and yeah, we're still looking for panels and contestants, and we're still looking for people to come and talk about their, you know, experiences in regards to online dating. But you don't have to go into detail. Do you know what I mean? We just want it to be real. We want it to be authentic, and that's who I am, and that is what it is. I will always represent. So finally, last shout out, Womanhood Academy, Sunday the 8th. Again, part of International Women's Month. I will be there. So for those of you who can get to Luton, please come to Luton on Saturday. For those of you who can't get to Luton, come to London. I'll be in Bethnal Green, at the Oval House in Bethnal Green. Again, I'll put some details below in the live and a couple of links as well, so you guys can come along. Really, really affordable. Family days out, children are free. And you know what I mean? Just come out and see what we're all about and what it is that we do. So, yep, there's going to be speakers at the Luton event. There's going to be speakers and performers and food and drink and all sorts of lovely stuff at both events. And I'm really looking forward to the weekend to come. So I'm going to jump off now because I literally have had about 12 hours sleep in the last 3 days. But yeah, this makeup. Just ladies, if you really want that long-lasting non-sheen thing going on, trust me, I put this on at 3 o'clock. Have not touched up at all, okay? So again, if you're looking for something that's breathable, healthy, I'll do a nice little close-up for you. As you can see, I'm strange, as you guys know. But yeah, gents, if you want your women to kind of look like me and feel confident in regards to what it is that it is they're wearing in regards to makeup, I think that's the biggest thing for us. So guys, you know what I mean? Treat your women, give them something nice, give them something different. So that's me, enough advertising right now, enough of you seeing my beautiful face, that's the way I feel. Have a wonderful, wonderful rest. Start Monday just knowing that if there's somebody out there that you need to reconnect with, that you need to make that contact with, ask them how they're doing, maybe not WhatsApp, maybe not a message. If you've got their number, call them. Yeah, they might not pick up. If they've got voicemail, leave a voice note. That's what I find. When someone hears you and speak from the heart, speak from within, yeah? And no matter how much it pains you to actually leave that message, just remember, we might not get that opportunity to make that call. Simple as. And on that note, good night, one and all. I appreciate those of you who are awake at this time of the morning. And thank you for feeling inspired by me, Samara. Honestly, take care. Good night. Go and look after them babbies, all right? Take care. Night and night, everybody. Much love, peace, blessings, prosperity in abundance. Rastafari, good night.